Whether you're welding with robots currently or you're looking to start, minimizing downtime in your robotic welding cell should be top priority. In this video, we'll go over some of the options available to increase throughput and ultimately improve your bottom line. Let's first start out with the most critical point in your robotic application, the torch. An entire production line can be halted when a single robotic welding torch fails, so it's important to ensure that the amperage rating and the duty cycle of your torch matches or exceeds what your application calls for. Construction of a welding torch contributes to its durability. Torches with a protective outer plating have a higher chance of surviving in the event of a crash than those without. In the case of aluminum armored torches, all that will need to be checked in the event of a crash is the TCP or tool center point before putting it back into operation. You can always verify the TCP through the use of a neck alignment jig. On the topic of durability, consumables also come into play. Just like your torch, it's important to ensure that the consumables you are using match or exceed the amperage rating and duty cycle that your application calls for. For contact tips specifically in robotic applications, HDS or high dispersion silver contact tips are recommended. The inner core around the bore consists of a dispersion hardened copper, and as a result, the inner core is extremely durable and heat resistant, while the silver coating compensates for the loss in electrical conductivity. Additional material options are available, such as copper and copper zirconium. Each has their own benefits, so just be aware of what material you are using and if it's giving you the results you desire. Also be aware of your nozzle material. Brass is used quite often here, but nickel plating can offer better heat and spatter resistance and increase the life of the nozzle 3 to 5 times over non-coated nozzles. Let's say for whatever reason you need to change a robotic torch neck during operating hours. Typically, this isn't a very fast process, but quick change necks and neckliners can greatly reduce the downtime caused from a neck change. For example, our Aburob air-cooled torch necks can be changed using only a single hex wrench in less than a minute, and the dual-locking keyways ensure that TCP will be unaffected. The use of neckliners, also known as jump liners, can reduce unnecessary downtime as well. You can have neckliners preloaded into torch necks so that you don't have to recut your wire liner every time you want to change out a neck. The same goes for cable assemblies. If a cable gets damaged, it can be replaced in a matter of minutes depending on the torch model. And since the torch and torch holder are untouched, TCP remains unaffected. Now that we've covered torches, I'd like to move on to specific pieces of equipment that can contribute to a more efficient robotic cell. Common systems we see used are torch cleaning stations and reamers. Reamers prevent weld spatter from building up on your robotic torch by inserting a reaming blade into the nozzle and spinning rapidly. Allowing weld spatter to build up on your consumables can cause improper gas delivery and cause porosity. When looking at reaming blades and torch cleaning stations, make sure that the clamp sets and blades match with the consumables that you're using. Wire cutting stations provide a consistent wire stickout so that you can have a proper arc start every time. When you're looking at wire cutting stations, make sure they cut using the clamp and shear method. Clamping the wire before cutting prevents the wire from bending and causing issues. A system that is recommended but not always necessary is an anti-spatter applicator. As we discussed previously, spatter can build up on your consumables and cause gas delivery issues. A reamer blade can remove most of the spatter, but anti-spatter prevents it from adhering to the consumables and makes the job of the reamer much easier. Our anti-spatter applicator is pneumatic and is activated by the robot's movement. A rubber applicator provides a seal so that anti-spatter isn't wasted or expelled into the welding cell. All of the items that I've listed so far can be found as standalone systems, but having a combined system that includes all of the above is the most efficient. For example, our TCS-FP has everything you need in one simple package. It has a single point connector for a true plug-and-play solution. Torch neck changing stations are available for some torch models. They provide the ability to change to different torch necks and angles automatically within the welding cell. Neck or jump liners will be required to use a torch neck changing station. If you have the need for multiple necks, a torch neck changing station can eliminate the need for manual neck changes or multiple robots with different necks. The major benefit to these systems is that a neck can be swapped out during the weld cycle for a neck with fresh consumables. The used neck can then be maintained offline and not interrupt the weld cycle. This can save an immense amount of downtime. Wire feeding is a part of your application that can be easily overlooked. Wire feed speed, wire feed distance, and friction within the system can cause a host of problems. These can be reduced or eliminated entirely with the use of a proper wire feeding conduit. The master liner conduit that we offer has features designed to mitigate the problems that we've listed. It has a highly durable outer sheath that prevents heat damage and debris from affecting its internal mechanisms. A good way to determine the status of your wire feed system is through a wire pull test. You can find more information about this in the blog linked below. Wire boosters can also help with wire feeding. Pneumatic boosters have been around for years and usually mount to the top of the drum. While adequate, they can cause other issues such as marring of the wire and the addition of oils and other contaminants. New products, such as electronic wire boosters, are more precise, cheaper to operate, and provide data collection capabilities. The last thing I'd like to talk about today is optical seam tracking. If you've had to rework welds because of improper fit up or parts moving within the cell, then you may want to look into fitting optical seam tracking into your operation. An optical seam tracker uses lasers to track in front of the welding torch and send data back to the robot to make on-the-fly adjustments to ensure it follows the correct path. There are multiple seam tracking options available, and you can find more information about ours by following the link above to our video all about optical seam tracking. Time is money, and when it comes to robotic welding, choosing the proper equipment that will meet your demands and limit downtime can make the biggest impact on efficiency.
Hey, thanks for watching. Check out some of our other videos, like this one. Don't forget to share your thoughts on this video in the comments below, and subscribe if you want to be the first to see the latest from Abacor Benzel.